स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ वीनस पब्लिक स्कूल। वी विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मैटर चैप्टर 3 क्लास 7th एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड एलिमेंट्स, कंपाउंड्स एंड मिक्सचर्स। यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड केमिकल, वी हैव स्टार्टेड द डिस्कशन ऑफ सिंबल्स, केमिकल सिंबल्स, केमिकल फॉर्मूलाज एंड केमिकल इक्वेशंस, एंड वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज केमिकल सिंबल्स। And chemical symbols, as we have discussed, these are abbreviations of one or two letters long, clear. And IUPAC, who have decided, who have make it a standard, that is IUPAC made it a standard, that is International Union for Pure and Applied Chemistry made all these symbols as standard, and they are worldwide, people are using them as a standard, as in their standard forms, okay. We have seen three important laws which says while we are writing the symbols, what are the things we need to keep in our mind for an element. If we are writing a symbol, what we need to do. So the first step is that the first alphabetical letter in capitals would be considered as its chemical symbol. The next rule says if more than one elements are there which are having same alphabet as they are starting alphabet, so what we need to do, we can take the second one in small letters as the symbol. So we left, so a symbol could be of either one or two letter. One letter, that should be always a capital, and if there are two letters, then they should be, first one is a capital and second one is a smaller, okay. And some of the elements or some of the symbols of few elements have derived from their Latin names. That's why, for example, we have taken for a few examples yesterday, like copper, iron, gold, potassium. They are having symbols derived from their Latin names, clear. And so today we are going to continue with our discussion with chemical formulas, clear. We need to discuss chemical formulas, clear. So what are chemical formulas? See, chemical formulas are nothing but just the representation of compounds, because what is it now? We have discussed symbols separately. Symbols are separately used to represent elements, clear? Like each and every element has a significant, has a fixed symbol. I hope you, all of you, have searched it on internet, searched the periodic table on internet, and you have seen the periodic table very carefully. There are so many elements in few of the periodic tables on the internet. They have just provided the atomic mass, atomic number, and the symbol only for all the available elements till now, but few periodic tables, few pictures or few charts of periodic tables, they used to provide you in that particular box, they used to provide you the chemical symbol, atomic mass, atomic number, as well as the common name of the element, clear. So this would, that kind of chart or this kind of picture will help you to understand or to memorize few of the commonly known or commonly used elements. You can relate it, you might have heard them before. So please, if you have not done it, do it, okay. Search the periodic table on internet, see the chart of it, clear everyone. So yes, now come back to the formulas. So chemical formulas are the chemical representation, are the representation of compound, clear. Basically it is the representation of compound using chemical symbols. Chemical symbols, which we have, like the last point we have discussed, chemical symbols, using chemical symbols of its constituent elements, because we are talking about compounds which are having some constituent elements, okay. So basically, what is chemical formula? Chemical formula is the representation of compound using chemical symbols of its constituent elements, clear. Let us understand this more with the help of few examples. After seeing these examples, you will be able to understand it, okay. And we also have discussed, while we were discussing compounds, we have discussed compounds are chemically combined, compounds are the substances which are chemically bonded, in which elements are chemically bonded or chemically attached together, clear, and in a fixed proportion, in a constant or fixed proportion. That's why it has a fixed proportion, like in water, hydrogen and oxygen are there, but two molecules of hydrogen, two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of oxygen is there always. So the so like if you will take any amount of any number of molecules or any amount of water, the composition will remain same. The composition of hydrogen and oxygen will remain, their ratio will be 2:1 always. Any amount of water will give you the ratio of its constituent elements as of 2:8. So what is H2O? H2O is basically a chemical formula of water. Clear? H2O is a chemical formula of water. Now, calcium carbonate. Clear? So calcium CO3. Clear? So in this, calcium, Ca represents calcium, C represents carbon, and O represents oxygen. Clear? So one molecule of calcium is 2, one molecule of carbon is 2, 3 molecule of oxygen. 3 atom of oxygen. 1 atom of calcium, 1 atom of carbon, and 3 atom of oxygen. So what would be the ratio of calcium carbon and oxygen in calcium carbonate? Any amount of calcium carbonate, if you will take, you will be getting always the ratio of 1:1:3. Clear? That is in a constant proportion. Clear? In a constant proportion of their masses. Clear? All these things we have discussed while we were discussing compounds, we have discussed the differences between the compounds and mixtures also. There also we have written these points, elements. What are compounds? Compounds are the elements that react to form new substances. And the composition of each new substance is fixed always. Clear? Composition. When I am saying composition, that means the ratio of the constituent elements. Clear? So CaCO3 is the chemical formula of calcium carbonate. Common salt, that is sodium chloride. The common salt is the commonly known name, but it is sodium chloride. S-O-D-I-U-M. Sodium chloride. Okay. Sodium NaCl. Okay. So NaCl is common salt. So you can prank your brother or sister with this new name of salt, that is NaCl or sodium chloride. Pass. You can ask your friend or your brother or sister, can you please pass me some sodium chloride? So they might get confused. You can trick with them. So what is sodium chloride? So here again, composition of sodium and chloride is 1:1. Okay, so one atom of sodium and one atom of chloride, when chlorine, when combined together chemically, they form sodium chloride. Okay, nitric acid forms HNO3. Okay, nitric acid. Here, so here hydrogen, nitrogen, and oxygen. Hydrochloric acid, HCl. Here hydrogen and chlorine. Methane, CH4. Here carbon and hydrogen, and carbon dioxide, CO2. So all these are the chemical representation. These are the representation of compounds using the chemical symbols of its constituent elements. Clear? So this is what chemical symbols are. Clear? Now, how they are formed? How we can write a chemical symbol for a particular substance? Okay, to understand this, we need to understand our next topic. What is that? Is valency. Okay, now starting this topic, I need to tell you a simple thing so that you can memorize it and so that you can relate it with this valency topic. See, suppose there are two students who are living in the different families, and they have never meet each other. Okay, they come to school, they meet each other, they find few things in each of them which they are missing in the family, or which they are not liking about their lives, or which they want, they are looking for those things. Okay, or in better way, like if they are satisfying their needs, clear. If two things are satisfying their needs, then they can make bonds very easily, clear. So similarly, if in nature there are so many elements, already some elements are there, okay, but let's suppose one element is having is lacking something and some element is having excess of it, okay. What if the one who is having excess of it will provide that excess to that who is having lack of it? Then what will happen? Equilibrium is maintained. Equilibrium is maintained, or we can say the bonding, the sharing of substance or the sharing of few properties are there, okay. And that's what make them friends. That's what make them come closer. That's what make them related to each other. Clear? Similarly, all these elements are there and they are like separate from each other. They are different elements, okay. But how they combined and how they form these compounds? How they are able to do this, okay? Because either like because any of them is required something and is having lack of something, and any one of them is having excess of something, clear. And when they share it, they becomes compound. When they share it, when they exchange it, when they satisfying their needs, they becomes like compounds, okay. So and the property, okay, or the tendency or the capability, okay, or the capacity of combining an atom or ion with another atom of ion of an element or a group of element is called valency. What is valency? The combining capacity of an atom or ion, okay. I will let you know what is the difference between atom and ion, okay. Atom we have already discussed, clear. Atom we have already discussed. We have already known that atom is the smallest unit of an element, and atom is having all the properties as the element has. Clear? So now what is ion? That I will let you know in a moment. But are we clear with the definition of valency? Valency is the combining capacity of an atom or ion of an element or a group of elements. Clear? Combining capacity. And when we are saying combining capacity, that means how easily or how difficult, how like easily they combine with other. If they have an ease of combining with others, then they are able to form compounds with them. Clear? And it is not compulsion that each and every element used to combine with each and every other element. Clear? Very few satisfy the needs of very few. So when they come closer, when they combine together, they form some stable substances, some compounds, and those compounds are being used or are used by human beings, okay. Nowadays our scientists used to research on different elements and they used to combine them chemically. They are trying to combine them chemically and they are getting newer and newer products. As if the product is not useful, they will just cancel the idea. They will not combine those elements forcefully. And if in case they get succeeded, they get a new compound which is very useful for the humankind, they can retain it, they can maintain it, and they will start producing it in a large scale. For example, fibers, okay. Artificial rubber, silicone, these PVC pipes, these plastics. What are these things? These are basically the things which are not there on earth primarily, okay. Polythene, okay. They were not there naturally, okay. So they were not the product of naturally combined elements, okay. Basically they are combined later on by the human beings. And they have got a new product called polythene, and which is the most successful and useful product nowadays. Polythene, polyester, plastic, all these things are man-made. And we have all the knowledge of hydrogen, we have all the knowledge of calcium. I'm taking an example. And we try to combine them. We have seen that they both are satisfying their needs. They both are having a very good combination capacity. So that's how we combine them together. We've got a new product. So one more time, I am telling you the definition of valency. What is valency? Valency is the combining capacity of an atom or an ion of an element or group of elements. Clear? So atom, we have discussed what are ions. I'm giving you an example. Suppose hydrogen. Okay, in nature hydrogen exists in diatomic state. That means in nature hydrogen always having two atoms in a molecule. In one molecule of hydrogen, how many atoms are there? Two atoms. Now suppose if I will take this hydrogen two atoms, means there are two electrons in it. Suppose two electrons in it, okay? And when we are saying two electrons in it, two electrons and two protons are there. Two protons are there, okay? So it is a completely concept of ions will take another lecture. So in next class we will discuss it in very detail, but for now we have discussed the valency, which is representing the combining capacity of an atom or ion of an element or group of elements to form compounds. It's called valency. Clear? Thank you so much.